So here is Nick Mullens, a fifth-year man out of Southern Miss, a free agent pickup. I think he played one game last year. He played in both of the preseason games this far. That went off to Sabir White. He played such a tackle.
It's unusual when you bring in your third quarterback. He's got 5 years of experience. He's got 17 starts under his belt. I mean, it's a great situation to have. You can't always say you can't ever have enough experience in that quarterback room. I think Josh McDaniels just likes that group overall.
They've got four on the roster right now. Do they keep three? Do they try it with two? Guys fighting with DJ Turner and Tyron Johnson, a position competition. Matt Collins is not here. He's the other guy that may have already secured a spot along with Adams and Hunter Renfro.
Nice job. He's going to set up third and four. But here's what you got to see. So you got the guy in the middle, right? Everybody's on the outside, okay? And so leverage is what you want to do. Get to the inside. So he gets to the inside. He beats his guy off the line of scrimmage. Now you have to beat that safety. Generally, if you can get off him and that guy's been run off, you got it made. Outside leverage with it. See how the outside play to the safety inside. It's like a gimme throw when you're in man coverage like that. And when I know when you guys get the line scrimmage, then your eyes light up.
You want to see that. You love that combination, those slants versus that man coverage.
Cole, three catches now, 44 yards on the night. And another injured Miami Dolphin, the second cornerback that has gone down. That's Keon Crossan. Back in a moment.
Push up inside.
Gotta have some position strength, guys. So you're in the green anchor.
Yeah, they've got John Simpson now at left guard, and Parham has moved over to the center spot. And he would serve as a backup in a lot of those positions, and another one gets beat around the edge. Or Gustin gets to the quarterback.
Just going to see Leatherwood right here. He's the tackle, and he's got to come off the ball. Matt talked about using the hands better. He's late with the hands.
He got it. Then that second step, he didn't get out. And he missed with that. Missed with that first punch and got overextended. Once you get overextended, he got it.
Loss of seven. Third down and 16. Mullens takes a hard shot, gets the pass away, and it's caught by Drake. Although he'll be run short as he gets stacked up quickly, and the punting unit will have to come on.
Yeah, we talk a lot about playing with confidence as a quarterback, but man, you know, along that line, you know, Leatherwood, I mean, just playing with confidence, right? Playing faster, using those hands, I think sometimes it gets off to a bad start, and it just really impacts what happens the rest of the game.
And looky what we found here, off a pick on the inside. They do that all the time. And so this is one of the pickiest fronts in football. And if you're not ready for it, it's about to sets up front. You know, one guy's got to be a little bit deeper and give yourself some room to maneuver. And then you got to pass things off and anticipate.
There's a point of emphasis coming in for the offensive coaching staff. Got to deal with those picks from the defensive front.
Now it's another athlete free agent, but I just think this kid's got a lot to give to this team. There's a lot of talent there. I think they can unlock it.
White will start out in the backfield here for the Raiders. A couple of tight ends. We've seen a bunch of this two tight end alignment here in the first half for Las Vegas. Mullens under duress again and able to find a man underneath. Good drop off there to White out of the backfield. And a gain of seven.
So when you go with the two tight ends, it balances your front. That's the first thing. The second thing it does, it should help the tackles because you have a good extra guy there. And then it also should help a little bit in your run game. You see where your strong safety is, if they're going to drop down. They're playing a lot of man stuff here, but they're also getting crushed on the inside. Those defensive tackles from Miami just walked the guards back. Get the center and the two guards covered. Kind of the eagle front. So you're going to get a bunch of one-on-ones.
Another slant incomplete. Johnson. Broken up by Mackenzie Alexander.
Alexander was all over.
Created enough separation to last year. Sometimes those receivers get a little antsy. They don't want to get in there quick.
Another change up front. Jackson Barton now at left tackle. But Dylan Parham is the guy who moves the center. He can play all three of those spots inside. Still getting up to speed when we talk to the coaches today.
That's so unusual, you know, that you have a player that can play the center in both guard positions, even jump him out the tackle. Played a lot of college football, and you love that about Parham.
Too many men in the huddle. Offense. By their penalty, third down.
Four-year starter at Memphis, actually played one season at tackle. The rest was spent playing both the guard positions, and now you see him at center. Now you talk about the guy that's going to make the football team for sure, but you love the fact that he can jump in and play center. He can play the left guard position. He can play the right guard position. Position versatility, especially along the offensive line, absolutely critical.
Especially kind of playing center as a rookie, that tells me he's a smart guy. Because they make all the calls.
Third and 11 out of the gun. To Drake out of the backfield. He's all down short. Fedulum is there to make the play, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, so that offensive line right now, they're getting pretty beat up. They're getting pushed back. They're not giving the quarterbacks a lot of time. At least this iteration right now of that offensive line.
It is a group of minus Colton Miller, the projected starter on the left side. No Brandon Parker, who hasn't played since the first preseason game. And no Thayer Munford, a couple of guys fighting for a spot on the right side of the line. Everybody else, though, it's kind of who they've got. It's getting a chance. Horton takes it off the bounce and ducks out to the 24.
Guys are playing pretty darn well.
Mullens back at quarterback. Can you drink? We'll take the toss here. Back to get off the right edge. Fedulum is there, breaking through for the stop.
Got to get his face in there and get a little more push. He was soft on the line of scrimmage. You don't see anybody getting pushed back. It just takes a minute.
They gained 7 8. Raiders got the touchdown with a very impressive opening drive. They've been struggling to muster much since. Ball popped out. Raiders were able to jump on it.
Inside out, and the guard, I don't know who it was, strained right past him.
I think it was Cotton, 67. Man.
You gotta be able to look. Part of that inside there when you're on the run, you got remember they did the counter to you earlier, they pulled to the outside, and pushed it down, and you gotta get your eyes up.
We had a warning.
Oh, thank you. We've come to the 2-minute warning in the second quarter. With the Raiders on top, 9-6. You're watching Raiders football presented by Visit Las Vegas.
You use it.
Got a third down and 10 here for the Raiders. Mullens has the time, looking across the middle, incomplete. Ed Johnson with some separation, but could not clear that last defender to get it over the top. It's fourth down. Cater Kohu with the breakup. So a touchdown on the first scoring drive tonight for the Raiders, and the offense stymied since then. This is the fourth consecutive punt for A.J. Cole.
So, straight man coverage. Safety sitting on the inside. That's a nice job of switching off inside. Really nice job.
Drifting to his right. I don't have a chance here. Right across the 35 into the 40-yard line. Third round draft pick a few years ago.